Angie in Wonderland, and as promised, I said I was gonna take you guys on a tour of my pantry, and that is exactly what I'm going to do today. I'm actually gonna say this is going to be the pantry tour before I changed some things around in this pantry. I actually had mentioned to Brian the other day that I wanted to take a few things out and add some things in there. So that is something that we are probably gonna start working on here in the near future. So without further ado, let's go ahead and take a look and see how I organize my pantry and what is in my pantry and what I'm gonna be taking out and changing in the near future, okay? So let's go. Right over here is my pantry. I have a sign that I have hanging up there that says pantry. How cute is that sign? So anyway, this is what the pantry door looks like. I painted this red a couple of years ago because my neighbor painted hers red. It just looks so good, so I copied it because it looks so cute. And then I just have a boxwood wreath on the front of it. And I'm just gonna say, you guys, this pantry is quite large. It is a very, very, very long and big pantry. This is like the biggest pantry I've ever seen in my entire life. But I have managed to fill it up, which is the reason why I'm going to be changing a few things. So let's go ahead and go through what I have in my pantry first. This is where I keep a lot of my, obviously, canned goods. You guys can see that I have a lot of beans. I use these black beans for a dip in the summer, and I think when they were on special or whatever and I was making it a lot, I collected a lot of black beans. So that is why I have a lot of black beans there, ladies. I have our kidney beans, obviously, for some chili, garbanzo beans, French cut green beans for like dinners, black eyed peas, yummy. You guys can see kind of how I have everything in here. Obviously, all of the labels are facing forward because if they weren't, that would drive me absolutely insane. Sometimes they do get turned and they're not facing the right way, but I will come in here and I will change them. Yes, it drives me crazy. Yes, it's OCD, can't help it, but that's just the way it is. It just keeps it look organized and it looks very, very nice. See how nice it looks? So anyway, I have chicken broth and then some rice and some little... somebody sent one of these to me and I can't remember. I think it was this one. I still need to make it, but someone sent that to me and I really need to make it. But anyway, I kind of keep everything in this little basket here. Applesauce, crackers. Here's some more crackers in here. Spaghetti. These are more snacks and crackers that I have in here. This actually, I don't know why the spaghetti is down here, but it needs to go. Like, let's do that really quick. Let's move the spaghetti up here where it's contained up there. I have popcorn and then some graham crackers up in there, and these are just like some small peanut butter containers that we can travel with or pull out when we're eating some apples. But anyway, this is where I keep a lot of the box stuff, crackers, malt meal. I have flour up here and rice, and it goes way back here. So coffee for when Brian's parents are here. And so that's what I keep up here. And then down here is where I keep a lot of like the pastas and stuff. More rice, some mac and cheese, potatoes. Some of the Alfredo stuff is back here. Pastaroni, you guys can see all that. Down here in this basket is where I keep some of our taco shells, egg noodles, croutons, some almonds back there, and some more taco shells. And then in this basket is where I keep all of our like packaged like dips and stuff. So all of our dips, taco seasoning, chili seasoning, all this stuff. You guys can see I keep it all organized in here. Same with this. This is just some extra seasoning that came with a taco packet. This is some egg drop soup that Brian, we bought this the other day and Brian's been wanting to try it. So we're going to try that. This is for some yogurt that we have. Again, cereal. So that's like the food part of my pantry. And then I have like extra chips and stuff that we keep up here for when we go to the neighbor's house or something that may have been free for Free Friday at Kroger. I have more popcorn here because I ran out of the container space. So I have popcorn here. Really not sure what's in there. Oh, those are like other tea bags that Brian has
brought home from traveling. This is for tortillas. So when I warm up tortillas, they stay warm inside of this thing. Again, popcorn jar. This is a pitcher. These I just have sitting here because those are actually take out for 4th of July. These I used for Christmas time. This part just kind of becomes a little bit of storage for a lot of the things that I use. Like my cake thing, my Keurig thing, which I could probably get rid of that. More storage down here, baskets, my little cooker thingy for our parties. More storage in here. What are those things called? Coasters and koozies for parties and stuff when Brian wants to take a koozie, all that stuff. Cake stuff. And more cupcake stuff down in there for cupcakes. I have towels and stuff down in there. Bags that I save for people to be able to take food home. And then all of this stuff up here that I have stored. Paper towels. Down here is all of my Christmas plates that I used, which are the Pioneer Woman plates that I use for Christmas time. All of this stuff, this needs to go in a tote that will not fit in these totes. Those are placemats and stuff that I used around Christmas time, napkins and stuff that I used around Christmas time. I'm going to back up. I have a lot of stuff hanging from that shelf. Okay, so some of the stuff that I have hanging here, like baskets, and these things are for like serving. Those things are for like servings, like when you put baskets and stuff on them. My popcorn bucket from Disney. Stuff up there, like my popcorn bucket that I can take to the movies with me. Cupcake holder, a cake holder, just all kinds of stuff. My, what is that thing? Pressure cooker? No. My, what is that thing called? Steamer. Paper towels, extra bags. I already explained to you guys about that. And then I have this white shelf unit in here that I store all of this stuff in. This is like more seasonal stuff. Plates. Oh, is that a plate for Valentine's? I should probably get that out. That's funny. So more seasonal up here, dishes and stuff. And then down here is where I keep like a fresh thing of baking soda, sprinkles for cakes. This is, you know, Jell-O's, puddings. And I have a vanilla pudding. Ooh, I didn't know that. So, and then more cupcake liners, food coloring, candies to put in dishes and stuff like that. All that stuff is sprinkles for cakes and all kinds of stuff. And then down here is where I keep a lot of my like seasonal napkins and plates and stuff for parties. Yeah, you guys can see that's kind of crammed in there too. That needs to be organized and probably put in there a lot better. Down here is the same thing, plates and stuff for parties, solo cups, all that good stuff. So that's what I keep inside of this cabinet. And then on the top is where I keep my Ninja, my tea maker, an extra coffee pot, and then my crock pot here. And then over here behind the door is where I keep my broom and my mop, which is over here. And then this makes it look like we're complete alcoholics, but come on, everybody has alcohol in their house, right? So we have a variety of alcohol. usually it's just Brian's makers or whatever he likes to drink. And then down here, I have some glasses that I store down here. I'll bring these out in the summertime. We have some strawberry Ritas, Hawaiian Punch that my niece brought last year. This is little my egg cooker. I keep that there. There's more alcohol back there. These are all those ice drinks that Brian likes to drink. There's some wine coolers back there. And then down here, I have cookie cutters inside of that. My chopper, another jar, another little bowl and dish and a lunchbox thing down there that probably can go. And then on the sides here, I just kind of keep some bags that we can take with us when we go traveling or whatnot. And then over here is where I keep this thing I bought at Hobby Lobby a couple weeks back. I keep onions in here, potatoes in there, and then extra bags down in there. And then right here, obviously you guys can see, is where I keep dressings. Our chips are right there, right as you walk in the door. You can just kind of grab them and go. Dressings and condiments all through here. And then down here is where I store a lot of my other stuff. This is my Christmas pitcher that I use for Christmas stuff. That's another pitcher that I use for like parties in the summertime. This is our toaster for when we go to Disney. Back there is another pitcher of some sort. I don't even know. And then this is our little insulated thermal cooler that we take with us. This is the one we got from Disney in December. This is just the bag that I take with us when we go to the neighbor's house, carry food and whatnot. And this is another cooler that I have. And then down here is where I keep all of my lids to my Tupperware, which is all inside of there. And then here is where I keep some of my other pans and stuff that I can't store. This is like my 5-quart cooker. And then down here is my Instapot. And then we have water in here. But that, my friends, is what my pantry looks like. So there you guys have it. That is what my pantry looks like. If you guys enjoyed this video. Oh wait, I actually forgot to tell you guys what my plans are to change this. Okay, let's go do that. All right, so once I get that all done, I will show you guys my after. I plan on putting some more shelving up here. That way I can store more of like my stuff like that, my pans and pots and stuff that I'm not using. So I can store those up high. And utilize this space a lot more because I need to be able to utilize it. That's a lot of space that's not being used. So I'm going to add another shelf, very similar to this one, alongside here. I'm going to take out this huge baker's rack and put shelving back there, just like this, back there in the corner. And then I'm going to add another shelf. I might, not sure, because I have a lot of this stuff hanging, which I need it to hang. But if not, then it's going to stay like this. But I know I'm going to put shelves right here because I want to be able to, I need more space. And this is just not working for me. So I need to be able to put some totes back there in the corner that I can, you know, fit that stuff in. So basically that's coming out. I'm adding more shelving in here, and that way I can get some of this stuff off the ground and put a lot of this stuff on top of the shelves as well. So that's what I kind of plan on doing. And that is going to happen here within the next couple of weeks, I'm hoping, crossing my fingers. So anyway, so now I'm going to go ahead and end the video here. If you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a huge thumbs up. Don't forget to share this with a friend who you think might like a pantry tour as well, or someone who you think might like my channel as well and who wants to come hang out with me sometime. Please do that. Please share. Also give it a huge thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you are new, and I will see you guys next time on Angie in Wonderland. Bye.